Hey, if you're feeling bored and unmotivated, then in this video, I'm going to share with you a couple tips that I think are going to help you flip that and get more motivated, inspired, and all of those things. So if you're stuck in a rut, creative blocks, all of that, then this video is for you. All right, so if you're feeling bored, unmotivated, first thing I want to say is it's so common. Every single artist, every single creative goes through that phase multiple times throughout their lifespan journey, whatever you want to call it, of painting, being a photographer, whatever the creative genre or medium it is that you use. I have experienced myself many, many seasons of burnout, many seasons of just feeling like, ugh, what do I paint today? I don't want to hop on Instagram or Pinterest and just have to like scroll to get inspired by something I see. So how do we break out of that? And there's usually two reasons why you are in that bored and unmotivated stuckness. And reason number one is usually that person or yourself, whatever, is insecure. Maybe insecure about where they're at in their painting journey, or comparing what they just painted to somebody else who did it better, or in their mind or whatever. That insecurity is a very common reason that results in being bored and unmotivated. And the second reason is busy, really overwhelmed, not much time, that kind of, you know, genre of reasons. So if you're in the first camp of feeling insecure, feeling like you're an imposter or like you're not good enough, my only real advice for you, besides what I'm about to list for tips and exercises to do, is to just power through. It might sound annoying, it might be frustrating to hear that, but it really does, just like anything else. Like if you're wanting to practice and get good at guitar and you're just starting, you're gonna suck. And if you're not putting in the time, you know, 10 minutes a day, whatever that is, then you're not gonna get better. It's just like anything, watercolor, calligraphy, working out and building muscle, whatever it is that you're trying to get better at and develop a skill in, it takes time. You need to have dedication and time. And so if you're feeling insecure or like you're not at the place that you wanna be, you have to be patient and you have to just power through, because every artist has crumpled up pieces of paper and canvas or whatever in the trash that you're just not seeing on Instagram, because we post our pretty little curated squares on there. And then if you're in the second camp of just feeling overwhelmed, not enough time, and just that camp, then I have a few tips for you. And hopefully this captures a lot of you guys, even if you are feeling like you're insecure or you're in the first camp. My first tip, I always feel way more energized or even more inspired before I paint if I clean my studio space. So if you just have a desk in your room or in your kitchen, or if you have a separate office or a separate studio space, having a clean painting area or a clean office or a clean room, whatever, is setting the vibe. We need to have the right vibe. We need to have a clean desk. We need to maybe have our favorite scent happening with our diffuser or candle or whatever. Set the tune, the mood, the vibe with the right lighting. Natural light is best in my opinion for painting. Clean white desk is my favorite with like not too much clutter. And then also putting on my favorite peaceful piano music or my painting Spotify playlist that we'll link in this video too if you wanna check it out. Best mellow tunes, background music for painting in my opinion. So tip number one is clean your space. Your mind is gonna be overwhelmed and cluttered, and you might not notice it, but it's gonna be subconsciously overwhelmed and cluttered when your space is cluttered. So make sure you clean your space. My second tip, this might seem like kind of out there and not related, but exercise. Go for a walk every single day. If you're not going for a walk or doing some sort of exercise or moving your body in general, take this as your sign and your little bit of encouragement to do so, because we are made to move. Our bodies need it. Are all of the things that go on inside of our cells and our bodies. We need to move our bodies. We need to be outside to get that fresh air, that sunshine, that vitamin D, all that good stuff. So if you know, 10 minutes in the morning or in the afternoon or whenever you, maybe on your lunch break or wherever, that makes a huge difference in how I end up feeling when I sit at my desk to paint. So get some exercise, maybe right before you paint if you can, or right before you sit down and do whatever your creativity situation is. So that you feel more fresh, more invigorated, and more excited to paint. So I just started going to the gym a lot, 4 to 5 days a week in the mornings. I never would have considered myself able to ever get up at 5 in the morning to go work out. But we're surprising ourselves every single day. And I've gotten into the habit, and I'm not saying that you have to go work out at 5 a.m, because that's not for everyone, but I never thought I'd be able to do this. And when the alarm goes off, I'm pretty pissed about it. But once I'm up and I'm actually at my workout class, I'm so happy that I did it. I feel the energy I feel after my workout, my 45-minute workout, I feel so energized. I feel so excited and happy instead of waking up with the aches and the pains and then just rolling out of bed and into my day. I'm able to like set aside time for myself where I work out. I sweat really good, sweat out all those toxins, get rid of the nasties, shower, get ready for the day. And I feel so amped and energized and inspired to paint new things and to get after the workday or get after the inspirations in paintings. So I really, really would highly recommend getting some sort of exercise in before you sit down to paint, because it really does lift the spirits. My third tip for if you're feeling bored and unmotivated and how to crack it is to literally schedule time. So again, I'm not type A whatsoever. Like, me writing in a calendar is just like, who are you talking? Are you a crazy person? Seriously? But I don't do that. But it takes discipline to actually continue to develop a skill and to find your own ways of inspiration, because I mean, different for every artist. So if you're like, I just don't have the time, but you really want to work on it, I bet you can find 10 minutes in your day. Or maybe you could automate something so that you can find 10 minutes in your day. Or maybe it's 10 minutes every other day. Whatever it looks like, and whatever it looks like, I think you should write it down in a schedule, maybe your Google Calendar or in a planner if you use one. Generini planners from Staples would be ideal. But actually pencil it in, as because it's so important. It's for our own mental health. It's for our own physical health. Even it's therapeutic. It's enjoyable. It's something that we love to do. So why not schedule? We schedule in when we get our hair done, and that's very like, you know, we like getting our hair done and it helps us feel confident and nice. Or we schedule in coffee dates with friends. Why not schedule in our dates with ourselves and our piece of paper, our brushes, and our watercolor paints, right? Oh, fourth tip. I would love to recommend bringing around a small journal throughout your day. I just recently started doing this, so I can't speak too much into it, but I love bringing around a small journal with me. And anytime I'm, you know, on a walk by myself at the beach, or I'm like just going about my day and something pops in my head that is inspiring a pattern idea or something I want to try painting later, write it down or just jot down what you're seeing on your nature walks. Maybe grab some flowers and press them in your little notebook and see how they end up dried and paint those flowers. There's inspiration literally all around you, and so many people get stuck in the scroll of like hopping on Pinterest and thinking, or Instagram, and thinking that they need to be inspired by looking at images of things when it's literally all around you. So go for a little nature walk, pluck some flowers or berries or, you know, whatever, and press and dry the flowers in here. Open your book later and maybe try painting it, or write down what you see on your walk. Maybe it's a field, maybe it's ocean, mountains, whatever. Write down what you see, or if an idea comes to mind, write it down. I'll link to where I got this little baby leather journal because I love it. It's so soft and delicious. And the paper is buttery and nice.
Sounds like I
want to
eat it.
Yeah. My fifth tip for breaking out of the bored and unmotivated stuckness is to find inspiration outside of your genre. So I have a full video on my YouTube channel dedicated to where I find inspiration. So definitely go check out that video. We'll link it right here in this video. But finding inspiration outside of your genre. So I'm a watercolor artist. I like to find inspiration from actual photographs, like really talented, beautiful photographers. I mentioned Fancy Bee on Instagram in that video, and she does beautiful, she takes beautiful, beautiful photos of florals. And I paint a lot of flowers, so I love looking at her Instagram and just seeing the color she captures, shapes, mistiness. Her vibe is really cool. I love looking at travel photos and textures that you see in ancient architecture or, you know, actual mineral earth pigments like malachite or gems and all of that. Like that kind of stuff really inspires me, or desert landscape photography. So, and even food can be an inspiration for painting. So think outside of the box, find some inspiration outside of your genre instead of, again, getting stuck in the scroll. Look outside of the box, think outside of the box. And obviously it's good to like follow along a YouTube tutorial and get more practice and develop a skill in that muscle memory. But when you're literally trying to sit down and come up with something to paint on your own, or just find inspiration for something, then this is really crucial to find inspiration outside of your genre. And then my final, sixth and final tip for busting the bored and unmotivated stuckness is to ditch perfectionism. I don't know when we all decided that we had to be perfect every single time. Maybe it's the age of social media, or I don't know, but we all have that. It's not just beginners. It's not, you know, just any certain types of people. It's everyone. Everyone encounters some sort of imposter syndrome at any stage of the game, whether you've been painting for 9-10 years or you've been painting for 9-10 months or weeks or days. So just remember that we all go through, and we all, like, I'm constantly throwing away stuff that I hate, that I don't like, but we got to remember to ditch the perfectionism. It's just not achievable, and that's gonna subconsciously make us feel really unmotivated because it's an excuse in our mind that we aren't good enough, and that's what's gonna be stemming into our unmotivation, our boredom, our lack of inspiration. So ditch it, maybe do some journaling about your issues with perfectionism, or your thoughts around perfectionism and why you think you're not good enough, or who you keep comparing yourself to in your art journey, and what you like about what they do, and maybe what is discouraging in your practice and your journey when you compare to them or whatever. So just like kind of vent it out, flesh it out in actual word form. All right, I hope that was helpful for you. I hope if you're feeling bored and unmotivated, or you're feeling creatively stuck, please try those exercises. I know it might seem like maybe that not all of them are that important or whatever, but they really, really do help me. Also, another very helpful book to read is The Artist's Way by Julia Cameron. We'll link to it here. I mentioned The Artist's Way book in my video on where I find my artistic inspiration, and a lot of you agree with me. It's a fabulous book. I recommend it to everyone who's in my courses. I also have a course coming up this fall. This is the year 2021. You may be watching this later in your life, in our life. But I have a course coming up on mindfulness and developing your own creative style. So if you want to sign up for the waitlist for that one, we're going to go through a lot of creative mindfulness, creativity blocks, and exercises that are going to help you develop your style. So make sure you check it out. I'm building the course right now, and it's turning out to be pretty awesome. I hope that was helpful for you. Get out of that boredom and stuckness rut, unmotivated rut. Get out there in nature, get inspired, go for walks. Maybe comment below with what your favorite of those tips were, or if you have another part of your practice that helps you stay inspired or motivated, because I'm always looking for more tips. So drop them in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.